drive up there, they test you, they never ask for any payment at all, never ask for any proof of residency or anything, then you get your results emailed to you. So it's very convenient and much more interesting than having to pay $200 for a test.
The U.S. land border may be open to Canadians again, but Canucks aren't driving over in droves because of the COVID testing requirement to come back. But one travel blogger in Quebec says he hasn't had to pay for a test when coming home.
When I went to the U.S. back in April, so 6 months ago, I got tests for free. It's really the only place in the world, where, at least that I know of, that you can get tests for free. The government over there decided that they will be subsidizing tests, COVID tests, for everyone and anyone with no citizenship requirement, no residency requirement, no insurance requirements.
He's gone back two times since, and all he did was make a testing appointment a few days before his return. He goes to drugstores offering drive-through testing and gives his American hotel as his U.S. address. While the tests aren't PCR tests, they are allowed, according to the CBSA's website.
Canada gives you 72 hours before your flight to get these results. So if you go to the Walgreens that has those rapid diagnostic tests, it's really, really convenient because you don't have to worry about having the results come in late, because this one is really quick.
Many say the very expensive test to come back to Canada should be scrapped, as it is a deterrent for those who may want to take day trips to the United States. And there are some in the business community who say that Ottawa needs to get with a program and be on the same page as countries that don't have the same requirement.
The reopening of the land border was a great first step and one very welcome. But the government needs to follow through now and remove the unnecessary, cumbersome additional step of the PCR tests that impedes business and tourism travel, so that families can reconnect and the economy can recover.
Damore says he'll be utilizing the loophole to travel for as long as he can.
You never know when this will change. It's not like it's a guaranteed right to get those free tests. If there's too many, there are too many Canadians crossing the land border, for example, now that it's open, maybe some Walgreens will decide, hey, we're going to really ask for U.S. Like, they can make their own rules, right? So there's that, you know, caveat that just to be careful. But if you book your appointment ahead, plan ahead, have a plan B, like in case that Walgreens doesn't work, like, you know where the other one is, and, you know, trying to plan ahead and be flexible.
In Vancouver, Maria Renouf, City News.